Hello students, today we are dealing with Bezier curves, which is prescribed in for 6th semester 17 series batch in computer graphics and visualization lab. So we deal with the header files glbar, glut.h and mat.h, and here we are defining the pi value as 3.1416. then we are referring animation variable with respect to 0. We are providing the structures for the new data types, our creation of new data types. You can see here we have given struct coordinates. Then we define xyz variables with respect to different coordinates, and we have given the variable 0.3d. We have a function binomial coefficients with respect to n and bino, where we have number of iterations with respect to k variable, and we provide binomial of k with respect to this g, where we are providing the factorial of that, and we have compute Bezier point. We have the Bezier curve function compute Bezier point, where we are defining the variable u, the Bezier point, the new control points with respect to 0.3d variable, the control points of that, and the binomial coefficients. The n value we define as n control points minus 1, and we have float as a Bezier functions, and that we define for x coordinate, for y coordinate, and for z coordinate. We are initializing with respect to 0. So we define it with respect to k iterations, where we are taking the value from 0 and we take until the n number of control points, and we go on incrementing them. We have this Bezier point functions to find the coordinates using control points. How to plot this Bezier points? Bezier points can be drawn with respect to the structure 0.3d and control points. Then we have GL int n control points and the Bezier curve points. So here we have the u variable. So we provide the dynamic allocation of memory for this binomial function, and we calculate the binomial coefficient using this formula n control point control points minus 1 with respect to binomial coefficients. We use the gl underscore line strip function to provide the different curve. Since we are dealing with the dynamic memory, here we provide k is equal to 0, k is less than or equal to n Bezier curve points. We go on incrementing it, and we are calculating the u variable value with respect to k divided by Bezier curve points, and we compute the Bezier points using this u, the address of this Bezier curve points, n control points, and the binomial value coefficients. We end this function as we had begun, and you can see one more point here. We are not considering the z coordinate. We have provided Bezier curve point with respect to x, with respect to y, making the z coordinate as 0. Let's move to the main function. We provide the argument counters and vector values. Then we provide the initialization of that. In display mode, we have used a double buffer, since we have many number of diagrams or many number of figures to get rendered. That is in animation way we are providing it. Then we are using the color model as that is RGB color model. Then we have initialized the window with the size 50,50. That is once again a user defined one. Window size with respect to 500,500. Then we provide the title of the window as flag using Bezier curves, and we have init function. When we have a init function, let's deal with that. Init function, we provide the clear color. We are defining the clearing the buffers of the color with respect to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, that is RGBA. Then we have matrix mode with respect to projection matrices. We are loading the identity matrix and we are providing the orthogonal projections with respect to 2D, that is 0, 500, 0, 500. Then we have menu here. In menu options, we are providing on the right click, we are providing two options. Option one will tell we don't have any animation for that object, that is the solid object we are seeking. In option two, we have animation, that is we are providing some kind of animation to our flag, which could be constructed using this Bezier curves. Coming to this display function, which is glut display function, we call the display function. Let's move to the display function. You can see here we have GL color buffer bit where we are clearing the buffers, color buffers, and we have N control points as 4, that is number of control points as 4. Then we have N Bezier curve points as 30, that is some 30 points we are referring or rendering for the curve. Then we have theta with respect to static value. So we have defined it with respect to 0 first. Then how can we provide the points to our control points to these Bezier points, our control points with respect to x, y and z coordinates. You can see here. So with the different values, you can get a different kinds of curves. So here comes the animation part. So where we are providing, at one value we are providing it with, we are initializing it with 40. Since sine wave, sine is the function which is very important also, which is by default we can use also. So we have used sine function here, where we are providing the theta value with respect to pi divided by 180. So with respect to 40 we have provided, with respect to y we have provided 60, once again like 40, 60 and so on. This part is totally for the animation purpose. Then what is the, how we are providing the animation? If animation is equal to 2, that is the option is equal to 2, then we are incrementing that theta value with respect to 0.2 every time. So point size of that particular points in the curve are 5. The point size is curve, width we are providing, the line width we are providing with number 5. Since we have to deal with the different rendering of pixels or different rendering of points, we are pushing the matrix and popping the matrix. That is, push and pop operations of stack are very important here. So matrix will be kept onto the stack every time the display function is called in an animation. And we provide the color to them with respect to these values in float. Then we have minimum 25 Bezier curves which will be drawn. So every time this function calls, this function will write 25 times the same function. So since it is a flag we are talking about, so we are providing it in three colors. See here, for I is equals to 0, that is we are initializing it with respect to 0, and we go on till 25 values, we translate it and we plot the Bezier points. Likewise, we provide the color to that. So for saffron color, for green color, and that is saffron color, white color and green color, we have provided the different colors, and with respect to 25 times we are calling that curves each time. You can see here we have provided the background color as white, again we have provided the background color as green. You can see, then we are popping the matrix as we had pushed it onto the stack. We provide the same color for that, and then we have a function GL begin lines. This is for the animation purpose. So when in animation, once again we are making the z coordinate as 0, we are providing x and y values and we end that. Then we post redisplay. So many times we are calling the display function again and again so that we swap the buffers. Coming to menu, as we discussed already, we have two options in that. Create menu. So whenever we come to this particular line, glut create menu, and the control goes to the menu. Then we have add menu entry, where we are adding that particular option. The first option is for flag without animation, so we get the solid object. And second option is flag with animation, that is whenever we click on the second option, we get a animated flag where it is flying. Then we have attach menu with respect to the right button of the mouse, and this as the main function ends and execution starts from. I hope you liked it and understood it, and if you have liked my video, share, like and subscribe. Thank you.